Welcome to 2017. So good to see each and every one of you here this morning. Would you stand to your feet? We're going to start off this year right in seeking God and welcoming Him into this place and worshiping Him for all that He is worthy of. Amen? Let's put our hands together.2017, that He would show us His power and show us His glory. Amen. Amen. Father, we have come this morning to worship You. You're the reason that we're here, God. We just want to tell You once again here in 2017 that we trust in You and that it's You that we need.
Enough. Everything I need is in you, Lord. Everything I need.
Yes, you're everything that we need, Jesus. Yes, God. You're everything that we need. Father God, we just want to take a moment within this worship time, and we just want to submit everything to you. We want to start off 2017 right. Father, first of all, would you forgive us right now? Forgive us of all of the stuff that's happened in 2016, things that maybe we caused to happen by disobedience or whatever it is, God. Maybe even those things that we haven't recognized, and maybe you haven't even shown us yet. But God, we just ask that you would forgive us right now. We know that you are just and that you are sovereign and that you are faithful to forgive. Father, we want to start off this year right. And God, we want to declare and we want to decree and we want to set our eyes and set our minds on you for 2017. God, we come together corporately seeking you, seeking your presence. God, we don't want to go into 2017 without you. We don't want to do it by ourselves. Maybe some of us in this room have been trying to do it ourselves, and it really just hasn't been working out for us. So God, right now, in this moment, God, right now, we say, have your way. And God, as we say that, as we maybe even mouthed at that, or we just kind of latched onto that, would you teach us what that means? Father, you are faithful to lead us, but God, would you teach us? Would you teach us how to follow? Maybe there are some of you in this room here today that have been struggling with, maybe there's something with finances, or maybe health issues. Whatever it is, maybe something going on in your family that hasn't been restored yet. I just want you to know that God is the God of restoration. Don't give up. Even when you're waiting on something and you don't maybe hear him, know that he's there. And maybe today that you've just been struggling, you've just been striving, and you've just been kind of feel weighed down. What I'd like for you to do in this moment is, however you do that, whether it is raising your hands in recognition that that's something that's going on in your life and you want to give it all to him and you want to lay it down at the foot of the cross, that's an outward expression of what's going on the inside of you. That's all that is. It's just an outward expression of saying, God, I recognize that you're God and I'm not, and I don't have it all figured out, but I know that you do, and I surrender to you and your will. So Father God, you see these hands raised, you see these hearts, you know every single situation in this room. And God, we want to give everything to you. We don't want to hold onto anything into 2017. We want to lay it at your feet, and we want to trust that you're going to work it out. But God, in the middle of that, you know, there's scripture that says, I believe, but help my unbelief. So God, in that, would you help us to trust again? Even maybe when we want to go pick that thing back up, Holy Spirit, would you nudge us gently, and would you remind us of who our God is, that he's full of power, that he's our provider, that he's our healer, that he's our restorer, that he's our savior. Father God, we truly are coming to seek you this year. Again, God, we don't want to go into 2017 without you. We want to go into 2017 declaring who you are and what we believe, God. And we believe that you are God and you are God alone. So, God, we just lay everything down. We pray all of these things in your Son's precious and holy name, the name of Jesus Christ. And everybody said, amen.
Father everlasting, the all-creating one, Loving Christ the Son, Jesus our Savior. I believe in God our Father. I believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. And I defended, suffered and crucified. Forgiveness is in you. Descended into darkness, you rose in glorious light. Forever seated high. I believe in God our Father. I believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus.
For I believe in
believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. For I believe in the name of Jesus.
Come on, whose name do you believe in? Whose name do you believe in? Yes, Jesus. Amen. Man, I love that name, Jesus. Before you take a seat this morning, would you turn to your neighbor? Would you welcome them this morning? Tell them Happy New Year. Tell them you're glad to see them this morning.
Well, good morning. Good morning. All right, all right. First, I'd like to welcome our online guests, Father's House. Let's give our online guests a nice welcome this morning. We thank you for tuning in with us on 2017, the first Sunday of a great new year. We know we have people that are online with us, not only around the United States, but around the world. And we welcome you to the Father's House today. And all of you came out. I hope your holiday was great. Everybody have a good Christmas? I had a great Christmas. And I got one special present, and I got to bring it back to Lisa, our KCLC director, who told me that she taught a certain little song to one of her grandchildren, and it was driving her grandchildren's parents, her son and daughter-in-law, just crazy. And it was, I want a hippopotamus for Christmas, right? So I've been singing that song. Lisa put it in my head, and I've been singing that song. So my wife, for Christmas, got me my very own hippopotamus. So I got a hippopotamus for Christmas. And he talks. He says all kinds of little things. So that's my Christmas present today, my little hippopotamus for Christmas. You know, just... that's what it's about. It's not about this grandiose thing. It's about families being together and just sharing some good times and a little present here or there and showing the love. And really, when you think about it, that's what Christ does for us. He wants to have that personal relationship with us. He wants to have a relationship where he knows that you want a hippopotamus for Christmas. He knows those in and out things. He knows all the deep desires of your heart, be they great or be they small. And he wants to be there for us. You know, the title of my message today is called In the Beginning, God Created. Here at the Father's House, our mission statement is very clear. We are leading people to become fully devoted followers of Christ. And in 2016, our goal here at the Father's House was to provide you with next steps needed to accomplish this mission together. So I hope that for you, 2016 was a great year. And maybe, as it was kind of our moniker in the beginning, maybe for some of you, you could even say that 2016 was my best year ever. And if that was the case for you, I hope that we can keep that momentum going into 2017. If you had a great 2016 spiritually, physically, emotionally, financially, whatever you did, God wants to reproduce in you in 2017 and take you to a new level. But maybe, just maybe, you started strong in 2016, but somehow you got off track. Maybe a major life event hit, caught you off guard, and you never quite recovered. Just that one major thing. maybe you just let the fire and the passion kind of subside. And you fell into what I used to do with my youth group when years and years ago, would have some kids that just not going to hell. Just on this side. Just don't want to go to hell. That's the only reason I want to be saved. Just so I don't go to hell. So maybe for some of us, we kind of fell off and we lost that fire and that passion of what a true victorious Christian life is. And right now we're in that place where we're just not going to hell. God wants so much more for you. Jesus wants to have such a better relationship with you. Or maybe for some of us, it's been so many years. It almost seems like it was since we were first saved that we felt any real fire or power or passion or joy or victory in our life. But you know, no matter how your 2016 was, whether you walked in victory the whole year, whether you walked in defeat, or whether probably like most of us, and I'm going to get in this category, it was a combination of the two. Had ups and downs, had some great victories, and had some things that seemed like they were setbacks. But you know, I think that we could all benefit from getting back to the place where we were when we first received Christ as our Savior. That place where God drew you, where you had just this passion, and it was just everything that you had pointed you to Christ. That draw was so strong for you to spend time with Him. So today, if you have your Bibles, let's open our Bibles to the very beginning. It's real easy to find today. Our scripture comes from Genesis 1:1. And it's real easy. Genesis 1:1, God tells us, in the beginning, God created. And we're going to stop right there. I know that you know that in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And then over the next 6 days, He created life as we know it today. But today, we're going to look at this verse in light of what God created in us when we submitted our lives to Him. And we're going to look at some spiritual growth principles, some next steps through the four steps of our TFH vision here to see what God wants to do with us in 2017. These next steps. Did you guys get your notebook on the 18th? That was pretty cool, huh? People just rushed in and gave you a gift. That was pretty nice. And on here we have know God, find freedom, discover purpose, make a difference. Inside your notebook was this card. Talks about how we grow. It's our vision, the four things we do, growth track action steps. And at the top is our mission, leading people to become fully devoted followers of Christ. Now, if you weren't here on the 18th, we gave everybody one of these. We do have these for sale at our media center, $4. Go out and grab yourself one. It's a great reminder and a great way to keep your sermon notes and everything just kind of handy with you in one spot. So today, as we look at the four things that we do at the Father's house, I'd like you to just, you know, as you get out your sermon notes, you'll see there's no fill-ins today. It's kind of wide open. I want you to just jot down what God says to you. He may speak through a specific word that I say, or He may just bring something to you that reminds you of that passion that He wants you to have. So our first step is to know God. I mean, that's where it all starts. It has to start with knowing God. That's also the first step of our vision. See, in the beginning, God created in you a desire to come into relationship with your Creator. He puts that in every man, woman, and child, a desire to come into the relationship with the Creator of the world and to allow Him to create in you a new person. 2 Corinthians 5:17 tells us this. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away, and behold, all things become new. So for all of you that are serving God today, and for those of you that are going to make a decision to turn your life over to God today, accepting Jesus was the first step. It's the basis for God to create in all of us new fire, new passion, new victory, and new joy. See, when we submit our lives to Jesus, we become new. And don't we all like new? Doesn't everybody like to get something new every now and then? Yeah, I mean, getting something new is kind of cool every now and then. We are a society of new. We'll you know, throw things away. I mean, the days of the washer repair and the stove repair and the VCR repair and the DVD repair, those are gone. You know, those shops pretty much don't exist anymore unless you're just really gifted in that area and you fix your own. We throw away, we get something new. See, what God wants to do in you is to create the purpose that he wants to fulfill in you, the purpose that he created you for. He wants you to come to this place in him where old things are passed away and behold, you are a new creature in Christ Jesus. See, when we come to Christ, he washes all the old stuff away. We get the proverbial kid do-over. You get to have a do-over in your life. And don't we all need that from time to time? See, in the beginning, God created in you a passion to not only know him, but to know him better, to be close to him. Do you remember, can you lock into that time and that place where you first submitted your life to God? Maybe it was a church service. Maybe it was in a friend's home. Maybe it was in the quietness of your own home. Maybe it was like me rolling down Route 33. And God just said, today's the day, son. You need to come back home. Do you remember that feeling? Now, I know the word says we walk by faith. But he created in us feelings. He created us with human feelings. Do you remember? Can you lock into that feeling that you had? That feeling of passion, that feeling of joy, that feeling of relief that you felt when you first accepted him. Not only does he want you to feel that on a regular daily basis, he wants you to know him better. He wants you to have a relationship. For those of us that are married, for those of us that aren't but have good friends, those relationships are supposed to grow. It's been 25 wonderful years, and our relationship has grown. It couldn't stay the way it was. It had to grow. We had to grow in many different areas. We had to grow to get used to knowing all those little habits that really aren't really cool, that really kind of get on each other's nerves, right? You have to grow to know what the other person is feeling so you can meet that need as husband or wife. And ultimately, and the very best, you have to grow in friendship. And so, see, the same is true with Christ. He doesn't want us just to be babes in him. He doesn't want us just to come to know him and say, okay, I'm just going to heaven and that's it. Now, God, just stay over here. No, he wants to have a personal relationship with you. So here at the Father's house, we've created what we feel is the way for you and I to get to know him better. We do a few things around here to give us all the opportunity to get to know Jesus better. The first thing that we do is weekend services, our Sunday services at 9 and 11. Do you remember when you wanted to be in the house of the Lord every single time the church doors were open? You couldn't wait for Sunday. For some of us, you couldn't wait for Wednesday or Thursday or Monday when you had meetings, and it didn't matter. And for some of us, that passion to be around saints and to be in the house of God was so strong that if our church doors were closed, we were seeking out another church. Hebrews 10:25 tells us this. Not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is in the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. Christ wants us to get together with one another. Can you serve God alone? Probably. Possibly is probably a better answer. Eventually, you're going to need somebody. Eventually, you're going to need that strength that comes with corporate praise and worship. Eventually, you're going to need that strength that comes from being around other Christians. And so here at the Father's house, on Sundays, we have services at 9 and 11. We have Saturday prayer and praise, another way to get closer to God. And this Saturday coming up, we are going to start our prayer and praise at 8 o'clock in the morning on Saturday. Come join us for prayer and praise. Give us 4 weeks to see if it makes a difference in your life. First Wednesday is another way that we feel we create the atmosphere for you to get closer to God. 7 o'clock First Wednesday, Pastor Terry has got a dynamic teaching that he is going to bring forth. It's all about the difference, what we would say a word church or a power church, and he is going to show us how we need to be both a word and spirit church and how the Holy Spirit wants to work through us and wants to work through this church to make a difference in this community. Our Epic Youth is moving to 6 o'clock on Wednesdays. Now, I'm very, very excited about this. It's going to give us an opportunity to minister to our youth in the middle of the week. It's just going to be this great time of bringing them in. The gymnasium over there is going to be open right after school, so anytime they want to come right after school, we're going to have games set up. We're eventually going to have some food. We're going to be getting with that real soon, Miss Pam. I got you on my radar. I need to get with you on that one. And it's just going to be this great time of bringing youth together and speaking Christ into their life. Maybe, though, we don't come to church for us. Do you ever think God's got another plan for you to be here? Maybe it's to exhort one another. You never know. Look to your left. Look to your right. There's a real people sitting there, real people with real feelings. Some of them are doing really good today. Some of them aren't doing real good today. You never know. We're really, really good at putting on that Sunday morning face, Sunday morning clothes, Sunday morning smile. How you doing? Oh, I'm blessed. Oh, God is good. Yes, all the time and all the time God is good. We know the lingo. We know how to throw it out. We know how to bury what's going on inside of us so deep so that nobody else knows. But you know what? Maybe just you being here today is a blessing to somebody else. Maybe God's got you here to smile, to shake a hand, to hug somebody's neck, to say, I love you, and I'm here for you today. So you never know the reason why God's going to bring us out. Another thing that we do here at the Father's House, and we encourage each other to do, is to read His Word. Now, this one I have to speak to myself also, because do you remember when reading His Word wasn't a chore? Do you remember when you first got saved and you couldn't wait to dive into this book to find out the truths that were in there, to find out what is this book, the Bible, all about? Joshua 1:8 tells us, the book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. I don't know about you, but I sure could use some more prosperity and some more success in 2017. What about you? You need anybody else need any more prosperity or success in 2017? It seems to me that God is telling us here to read His Word, meditate on it day and night, and then He is going to fulfill the promises of His Word through us as we submit our lives to Him. See, in 2016, we had a plan. We provided a Bible reading plan to read the Bible through in 1 year. We had Bibles that we sold that fell in line with that, what to read each day. We had it online where you could pull it up on your phone or your computer. Now, some of us may have made it through and some of us didn't. If you read the Bible through in 2016, I'd like you to set a new goal for 2017. Whatever that goal is, maybe it's like our pastor who's going to read the Bible through again. Pastor Terry reads the Bible through every single year, and he says it's amazing because even though he's read it, that same portion of Scripture, every year God pulls something new to him in a portion of Scripture that he's already read. Maybe you say, well, this year I'm going to do it a little different. I'm going to get maybe a specific devotional and follow the readings in the devotional. Or maybe I'm going to do more of a Bible study. I'm going to take different books of the Bible and kind of pull them apart a little bit. Whatever it is, let's not forget to read His Word. The other thing that we do here, we have Growth Track. We have 4 classes that help us all to grow. Step 1 is on the first Sunday of each month, and that's called Follow. And it's where we learn what it means to follow God. And step 1 is now going to take place at 11 a.m. in the Impact Center. You don't have to sign up. Just show up. Matter of fact, Everybody here could go next door upstairs to the Impact Center and go to step one if you haven't been to step one. Now, where's Tanya? Tanya's saying, oh, no, I don't have room for everybody up there. But we'll make room. I'm telling you, if you haven't been to step one, this is where you start. This is one of the ways that we learn how to follow God a little bit closer. Another ordinance that we follow here at the Father's House is to be baptized. If you haven't been baptized, what a way to start out your 2017 than following what Christ would have us to do. We will be doing baptisms next Sunday at the end of second service. If you have not been baptized and you would like to be baptized, if you take out that connection card that's in the pocket in the seat in front of you and just write on there, send me information about baptism, we will get you all the information and sign you up to be baptized next week. I mean, think about it, starting out your year with one of the great ordinances of the church and following in the example that Jesus Christ did for himself. Well, the second step that we have here is to find freedom. See, in the beginning, God created in you a passion to let go of your old life. He does not want those things to hold you back and to hold you down. Again, going back to 2 Corinthians 5:17, it says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things become new. So how do we do this? How do we let go of the old life? Because don't those things just kind of attach to you sometimes? Those same things that had you holding down, they just kind of grab a hold of you sometimes and you say, God, how am I going to let go of this? How can I move on? We're going to follow what the Scripture says. And here at the Father's House, we say that those things, healing, relief from our old life, moving on, happens in the context of small groups. See, the Father's House is a church of small groups, not just a church with small groups. We believe that true healing from your past comes in relationships that encourage us and hold us accountable. I'm here to tell you today that if you're trying to get rid of something in your life and nobody else knows about it, it's not going to happen. If you are the only one that knows your stuff and your junk, you're in a lot of trouble. You can say, well, I've given it to God. Yeah, you have. So what did God say? God tells us in James 5:16 to confess your trespasses, not to him, but to one another, and pray for one another that you may be healed. When we knowingly sin, we ask God to forgive us of that. But then the step for healing is to talk to somebody. You need somebody in your life that's going to hold you accountable. Somebody that's going to encourage you. We all need three types of people in our life. We need Paul. We need somebody to speak into our life. We need Timothy. You need to be speaking into somebody else's life. It doesn't matter if you've been saved all your life or if you got saved last week. You need to be pouring yourself into someone else because somebody poured themselves into you. The last person we need is perhaps the most important. We need that person that Barnabas was to Paul. We need somebody that loves us but is not impressed with us and is willing to hold us accountable for those things. But see, the onus is on us because you have to give someone permission to hold you accountable. You have to be able to share what's going on in your life, whatever it is that's holding you back from that true joy, that true victory in Christ. You got to share that and then let somebody hold you accountable. Our next small group semester begins February 12th and is going to run for 10 weeks. Next week, we begin sign-ups. We'll be able to sign up out under the tent and sign up online. And also through our website, it's www.thefathershouse.com. We have different types of small groups. We have equip classes that will teach you daily principles that you can put into use to have growth in your life. We have Celebrate Recovery. We have a brand new Celebrate Recovery class starting. It'll start on Monday nights. Celebrate Recovery is a fantastic program. It is a fantastic small group that is for anybody that has hurts, habits, or hang-ups. Anybody not have a hurt, habit, or hang-up? I think we all got those. I think everybody could benefit from that. So again, celebrate recovery. It's going to start. We'll have Bible study-based groups for those of you that like to get into the Word and really study that Bible, hook up with like people. We'll have some groups that are just purely activity-based. Man, we're going to get together. We're going to form relationship. We're going to go out and do some activity that we're all involved in and at the same time encourage one another and hold each other accountable. We'll have service-oriented groups, groups that want to go out and just make a difference out in the community. And for any of you that are saying, wow, that might be kind of cool to lead a small group, it's not too late to lead a small group for our next semester. If you would see Tanya Thompson, who's probably in the media center right now, she directs our small groups. She is our director of small groups. And you can also email her at nextsteps@thefathershouse.com. So with all that, our second step of Growth Track is Growth Track Step 2 that happens on the second Sunday of each month. And this is where we learn better how to connect with one another here at the Father's House. And this is so you don't ever, ever think that you have to walk this Christian life alone. And it's 11 a.m. in the Impact Center, and you don't have to sign up. You can just show up. That's right. So next Sunday, 11 a.m. upstairs in the Impact Center. Another way that we all find freedom is through prayer. As you spend time with God and allow the Holy Spirit to help heal you. See, the second part of that James 5:16 verse says, "The effective, fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much." Now, effective, fervent means passionate and strong. Prayer of a righteous man avails much. So I have quoted this verse. I've taught teachings and sermons on just this verse alone. And over this last couple of weeks, I got to thinking, I don't know if I truly know what the word avail means at its core. What does that word truly mean? I quote it, I throw it out there. So I figured, son, you probably ought to know what you're throwing out there in case somebody says something. So I found some great synonyms for the word avail. Helps, aids, assists, benefits, profits. So this verse tells me that if I were praying more, I'm going to keep this to me. If I were praying more, I would get more help, more aid, more assistance, more benefit, more profit, which for me would probably cause me to complain and feel sorry for myself a whole lot less moving forward into 2017. So I don't know about you, but I'm going to pray more in 2017 because I need these things in my life. You might say, I don't know how to pray. The disciples, the very men that walked with Christ. And this wasn't at the beginning of their 3.5 years with Christ. Matter of fact, it was toward the end of their walk with Christ, that 3.5 years, came to him and said, "Teach us to pray." You may be feeling that right now. How do I pray? Again, Saturday morning prayer and praise from 8 to 9. We're going to start at 8. We will have you out at 9. And what happens during prayer and praise is we get together. Miss Andrea is going to lead us in some fantastic praise and worship. We're going to sing. It's going to set the stage. The atmosphere of the Holy Spirit falls in here. Pastor Terry is going to bring us a teaching about how to pray. Different types of prayer for different types of situation in your life, in my life, and in the community. And then we're going to spend about 30 minutes. Well, before that, he's actually going to give us this year a free, I said free, so come on out and get your free how to pray book. So if, again, you're not sure how to pray, come out and get this free how to pray book. But yet, wait, there's more. There's more, because not only will you get this free how to pray book, you'll get a 30-minute free time on how to practice that prayer. We all go off. We all spend time with God. It's very laid back. It's very mellow. Some people are in the seats. Some people walk the campus. Some people walk the buildings. Our connection cards are up here. Sometimes when you don't know what else to do, you come over, you pick up a connection card, and you just begin to pray for someone else's needs. And when you do that, God's just going to reveal great things to you. And then we'll come back together. We'll have another fantastic time of praise and worship. And then we'll have a close. And sometimes that close may be a short follow-up, whatever Pastor Terry was teaching. It may be, what did God speak to you? What did God speak to you? Or a corporate time of exercising prayer together. 8 to 9, guys, come out, start your year in prayer. Again, give us 4 weeks in January. See if it doesn't make a difference in your life. And see if this time next year in 2018, you're saying, man, I made almost every Saturday morning prayer and my life was changed forever. This year, we're also going to do, as we find freedom, through 21 days of prayer and fasting. See, in the beginning, God created in you a desire to fight off Satan's attacks. He did not create a desire to give in to Satan, but a desire to fight off Satan's attacks. And do you remember when you truly, really wanted to overcome what Satan was giving at you instead of just trying to just roll with it and survive? 21 days of prayer and fasting. And where does this come from? It comes from Mark 9, 28 and 29. It says, when he had come into the house, that's Jesus, his disciples asked him privately. They had been out and they had tried to cast out some demons from some people and they couldn't do it. And they said, why could we not cast it out? So we can also say, why can we not overcome Satan? And he, Jesus, said to them, this kind can only come out by nothing but prayer and fasting. Sometimes the attacks of Satan are so strong that you got to get back to what Christ did when he spent 40 days in the desert to ward off what Satan was going to try to tempt him with, and that was with prayer and fasting. In your Sunday experience guide, there's this sheet here. It talks about 21 days of prayer and fasting. Our 21 days will begin on Sunday, January 8th, and will end on Saturday, January 28th. Our timeline is in here. There are foods. There are just encouragements, everything you need to know. It's going to give you some good websites to go to. But again, if you've never done this, let's give it a try. And you say, look, I got to eat. There are different types of fast. You may choose to do a Daniel fast. You may choose to do just fast a certain thing in your life. But remember what fasting is. Fasting is not, all right, it's not, no, I'm not going to say that. It's not, all right, I'm just not going to have cookies, the rest of the Christmas cookies for the next 21 days. By the way, I have no idea what we're going to do with all the Christmas cookies. I guess I'm going to have to eat them all this week. I'm not sure. But it's not just that. As we deprive ourselves of something, and the something in the Bible was food, it's then that time to spend with God. It's time to let the Holy Spirit fill that place where whatever that void of that other thing was. See, true strict fasting is not eating at the meal time. Spending that time in prayer. Spending that time hearing from God. So I would encourage all of you to pray. Spend some time with God and see what He directs you to fast this year. Give God 21 days. Form that good habit. Experts say if you do anything for 21 days, you can form that positive habit. And you give 21 days to God, an hour on Saturday to pray and see if God does not manifest results in your life. The third thing here that we do is to discover purpose. God created in the beginning a thirst for you to know, why am I here? You can go out and ask people that are saved, people that are not saved. One of the biggest questions people have in their minds is, why am I here? What's my purpose? Why was I born? And why was I born at this time and not back in cowboy days or not back in the Knights days or not back in the Revolutionary War days or forward where we're flying around with backpacks on us instead of driving in cars? Why was I born now? People have this innate desire in them to know what that means. Ephesians 2 and 10 tells us this, for we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. Do you know that before God formed you in your mother's womb, before the very foundation of the earth, he called you by name. He knew who you were going to be. He knew where you were going to be born. And in your DNA, he created you with a certain purpose. He created you with certain likes, certain dislikes that lead you to fulfill the purpose for which you were created for. But sometimes it's hard to figure out, what is that purpose? How do I do that? Growth Track Step 3, the third Sunday of each month, is Discover. It happens at 11 o'clock in the Impact Center. You don't have to sign up, just show up. That's right, we're all going to show up. we're going to help you discover purpose with two different ways. First is through a personality profile test. It's going to just kind of let you know how God wired you. See, He wired us all different. Some of us He wired as just, you know, loving the people and people persons. Thank you. Some of us He wired as, you know, detail-oriented people. Some He wired with different giftings. So what is that? We're going to give you a little personality profile test to help you kind of figure that out. Help you go, that's why I react like that. That's why I lean toward these kind of things. The other thing that we're going to go over with you is a spiritual gifts test. We're going to see what are the gifts that God placed inside of your DNA and so that you can fulfill a purpose. You're going to discover God's three reference points for your life: how He made you, how He has gifted you, and where He wants to place you. And these are all so that you can fulfill your purpose on the earth. So again, growth track step three. The last part of our kind of values here at TFH, what we do at TFH, is make a difference. See, if we just know God, we find freedom for ourselves, we get rid of all of our junk, and we live this victorious Christian life, and I discover my spiritual gifts, and I figure out why I'm wired like this, and why my wife's wired like that, and why my kids are wired like this, and then I just sit on it and I say, bless me, Lord. Thank you for all this wonderful life. We're missing the big picture. The big picture is to make a difference for Him. See, that's the fourth step. And in the beginning, God created in you a desire to show and tell others about Christ. See, remember when? After you had first asked Jesus into your life, do you remember that? Do you remember that you told everybody? Your mom, your dad, your friend, the grocery clerk, the waitress. You couldn't wait. You were so happy that you had finally found the Savior of the world, that you would tell anybody that would listen about your new best friend, about this man. What the woman at the well said, come with me. Come with me and meet a man who told me everything about myself and changed my life. This woman went and told the entire town. That's what Christ puts inside of us for us to go and tell others. Psalms 96:2 says, sing to the Lord, bless His name, proclaim the good news of His salvation from day to day. See, we make a difference by telling, inviting someone because someone told or invited us. Romans 10:14 tells us this. How then shall they call on Him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in Him on whom they have not heard? Our last step of growth track is on the fourth Sunday of the month, and it's about serve. It's where we learn how to make a difference, where we learn how to use the gifts that God has given us to make a difference in somebody else's life. And that is on the fourth Sunday at 11 o'clock in the Impact Center. And we're all not going to sign up. We're all just going to show up. That's right, Tanya. You better get a great big room because we're coming for you out there. Ezekiel 22:30 says, so I sought for a man among them who would make the wall, who would fulfill His purpose, who would do what I created him to do and stand in the gap before me on behalf of the land that I should not destroy it. See, again, if we're all just here for us and it's just all good for me and hallelujah, bless God, and I'm having a great life and things are going wonderful for me, and if we all decided to live our lives that way, Christianity would become stagnant. It would not reproduce itself. We have to reproduce ourselves in others. We can make a difference by serving on the Dream Team, our awesome TFH volunteers who every week create an atmosphere on this campus where we can all experience the very presence of God. What if you were the person who joined a Dream Team and stood in the gap for somebody else and their life was saved and not destroyed? You never know. It's not about value. It's about the role that we play. See, A lot of people say, well, you know, it's the preacher and he's the one that you know, preaches the sermon and people get saved and people come back to church because they love the preaching or they love the worship. And while those things are true, most people will make up their mind whether they're going to enter the sanctuary and enter into whatever is going on by the time they hit the front door, by the time they hit the doors here, by how welcome they feel, by the atmosphere that's already been created for them. You know, you go into a store. We all know, I'm not going to blast any stores, but you all know the stores that have lousy customer service. And it's like, oh, I really don't want to go to. I really want to go to this other store. Because we all know those stores that have great customer service. Some of those stores that have great customer service, the prices aren't the best. Prices are a little bit higher. But for a lot of us, we'll go back there because of the experience, because of the atmosphere that they create. So we come together as dream teamers to create an atmosphere for people to experience Jesus. So our four categories of next steps that we can all get involved in 2017 to guarantee to walk in the fulfillment of what God has designed for us in the beginning. He designed this in the beginning. To know God, to find freedom, to discover a purpose, to make a difference. You know, you may be sitting out here today. You may say, well, Pastor Tim, you know, that sounds really, really good. And it sounds to me like you're talking to people that have been going to church most of their lives, aren't involved in church. But, you know, I'm a little far away from that point right now. It's not really where I'm at in my life. So for a few moments, could we just kind of bow our heads and close our eyes? And if I'm talking to you today and you say, well, you know, some of this sounded good, but some of this sounded a little foreign. I really didn't even quite understand all of it. It seems like I got stuck on that first point of knowing God. I really don't know God. Don't have him in my life. This is the opportunity for you to start 2017 the very best way. See, it is no coincidence that January 1st of 2017 begins on a Sunday morning and you are in the house of God. That is not a coincidence. That is designed before the foundations of the earth. If that's you today and you'd just like to say, Pastor Tim, look, I need to know God today. I can't do none of this other stuff until I know God. Just raise your hand. I just want to pray for you. I want to help you start 2017 in the very, very best way you absolutely could. So I'm going to assume that we're all saved and we're all going to heaven. That's a great thing, but it doesn't end there. Great singer-songwriter, 70s, late 60s, early 70s and 80s, Andre Crouch wrote a song, and it's called Take Me Back. And the song says, take me back, dear Lord, to the place where I first found you. I'm going to play that song this morning as I talk to you a little bit more. See, the story and the message behind this song is that, as with anything, we can get into a rut in our lives. We can get into habits in our lives. We can just begin to walk a path that was the same. But this song says, take me back, dear Lord, to the place where I found passion, where I found victory. My next call to you today is, if you're at a place in your life where you say, Tim, I am saved. I am going to heaven. But you know, right now, I need to get back to that place where I first believed. I need victory. I need joy. I need to find freedom in my life. I want you to stand up and join me down here. I want to pray for you today. Come on, don't hesitate. Don't hesitate. Let's find victory today. Let's get to that place where we first received him. That place where God was just there and he was the most important thing in our life. Where there was passion, where there was fire. I'm standing right here with you. I'm standing right here with you. God has been dealing with me about this for the last month. of getting back to that place in my life where that passion and fire is what I need. As he has placed me in a new ministry, I went through just like a little up and down real quick. It was new, it was awesome, and it was so fantastic. And then in about 2-3 weeks, I found myself relying on experience. I've done this. I did this for 10 years. I can push play and do this. God said, no, no, son. I need to take you back to a new place because I got a new thing for 2017, and I need to refresh and renew you. So that's what I want for us today. That's what you want today. Let's just raise our hands, and I just want to pray over you, and I want you to pray. And Father God, today, Lord, I ask that you would take us back. Take us back to that place where we first found you. Fulfill in us in 2017 the purpose that you created us for. God, we humbly lay our lives down. Lord, we lay our business down. We lay our money down. We lay our relationships down. We lay our thoughts and our feelings. We lay down that I want. And God, it's what you want in us this year. Take us to a new place, Father God, please. Yes, Lord. We've tried, but we can't do it alone. God, we love you today, and we just say, take us back, Father God. Take us to that new place. It's all about you, Father. We lay our lives down today. We submit, we break our will, Father God, and we say, instill in us your will. Call us to new things in 2017. Pour out your spirit upon us in 2017. To the place, Father God, where your young men see visions, your old men are prophesying, Father God. There's healings in the house, Father God. We call for salvations. We call for healings in the house. We call forth that chains are broken. Addictions are gone in this house. Because we have submitted ourselves to come back to a new place in you. God, we love you today. We just say thank you for your spirit. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. I want you to be fulfilled in 2017. Keep this passion. Keep this fire going. It is so important that we just stay with all of these things that God has for us. We need to know him. We need to find our freedom. We need to serve him, make a difference in someone else's life. Man. You know, God is so good. He's got so much for us. I think we're just on the tip of the iceberg of what God actually has for us. I'm going to ask our ushers to come on down, and as they get ready to take our offering today, we have a connection card. It's right in the front of your seat, and this is the way you connect with us. If you have a prayer request or a praise report, please put that down there. We love to pray over these. We love to rejoice with you. Let us know what's going on in your life. Remember our next steps, know God. Baptism next week, if that's something you want to put down here. Saturday prayer. Join a small group, 21 days of prayer and fasting. Complete growth track. Maybe that's your goal this year. Maybe you started and you went to a couple of them you haven't completed. Let's make a difference. Invite somebody to church. Tell somebody about Christ. Join a dream team. Ushers, you can go ahead and start passing buckets out. If you're a first or second time guest, we'd love to connect with you. If you could mark that on here in a little box that says first or second time guest. I can't push First Wednesday enough. Please make it a goal in your heart. Purpose yourself to come out to First Wednesdays. It is a time of hearing from God. It is a time of worship beyond anything that we are going to experience any other day in this house. Holy Spirit is here. Our teaching is great. And in our first Wednesday in February, Pastor Terry's pastor, Pastor Rick Godwin, is going to be here. Now, I am super excited to meet Pastor Terry's pastor. I want to get him alone in my office because I want to hear some stories. I want to hear some stories about young Pastor Terry. But beyond that, Pastor Rick Godwin has a word for this house. This is a man that has been fulfilling his purpose his whole life. He has served God. He's pastor in a church, and he's going to come and he's going to minister the word. And this is a great, great opportunity to really meet the man that had such a huge impact on the man that shepherds and leads us. But again, this coming Wednesday, Pastor Terry has a great word, so let's come out and let's hear that. Youth on Wednesday night, fasting info is in here. Growth track, again, if you haven't been to step one, upstairs in the Impact Center, 11 o'clock, we are ready for you. Guys, let's stand and worship this service out. Let's give our heart and everything that we can to worship God, and let's take this out in prayer and praise. Thank you.
Of your great love, now I live. I was dead, but now I breathe. Awaken to your grace, so free. In the power of your cross, now I live. Salvation.
Thankful that you chose to worship with us here this morning. Our prayer team is on either side of the stage. They would love to pray with you if you have anything that you need prayer for. If you've never met Pastor Tim, him and his wife Brenda are going to be out on the patio, and they would love to meet you if today was your first time with us. We hope that you enjoyed today's service, and if you did, would you invite someone next week? Ask God this week. Say, who is it that you want me to invite next week? We're going to be starting a brand new series. I cannot wait to get into this series that Pastor Terry has for us. We love you guys. We hope that you have a great day. Be blessed.
Salvation, my freedom, you gave your all for me. Forever, you made a way for me. You came to my rescue. You came to my rescue. Calling on your name, calling on your name. Love came down. You came to my rescue. You came to my rescue. Calling on your name, calling on your name. Love came down. Salvation.